Yeah, for myself, I have started judge.
Okay, so one person can record, that's fine, but be there for the entire session, that's all.
Anyway, this will come to your Google Drive, I think.
To my Google Drive, it will come, I think, whoever is recording, because I am the initiator of this.
Correct, correct. Then you can share with others.
Right.
Okay. Yeah, good afternoon, everybody. DSS. Okay, Bell team not gone through this documentation, right? They said. Well, let me take through the what is DSS, that application, then we'll go into details. So it's easy for even if you don't go through the pre-reads or the technical documentation. So DSS is basically decision support system, what we call, named it. This, what are the KPIs you want to in state or client, state, basically client, for us it's state or ULB, can take can decide on what kind of KPIs they want. Based on that KPIs, we can build our dashboards, the decision support system dashboards. So for Punjab, this is a Punjab dashboard, what we have recently implemented for Punjab client. For Punjab, we have property tax, trade license, PGR, compliance system, water and sewerage. For these four modules, we have implemented a DSS. So when in any module wise, some dashboards will be there. This is a overall dashboard. We calling it is a SURE, state urban real time executive dashboard. So if you see here, there is a top bar where overview, very high level numbers like total collection, achievement, application, SLA, and this complete data will be shown. Currently it's showing for current financial year. So means 2021, April 1st, 2022, March 31st, 21. So how many dashboards we configured for four modules. Those module wise very high level numbers we can show. This is still you can change, that is, everything is configurable, whatever you are seeing here. Suppose property tax for Punjab, total collection and total properties assessed we have put. You can change this also as per your module requirement, as per your client requirement. Okay, so this is the overview, right? Let's go to this and click of this. Again, the detailed overview dashboard is here. That is very high level. Here, if you see this top bar, whatever you're seeing here, this is, you can filter the data using this bar, like date, DDRs, ULBs, the services and denominations, you can change it. We change the date here. So it's showing the data for 1920 financial year. You can see charts, visualizations. These visualizations are whatever we configured for Punjab, that you are seeing. You can configure whatever you want. Means it depends on your requirement. You can configure the visualizations here. Here we configured overview, what is today's collection. This is irrelevant when you see for 1920. Even if you see for 2021 also, today's collection, the field itself, it's today's collection. It's a today's collection. Not when you change to financial year also, it comes with today's collection only. And other things will change. Total collection. So in you see here. In 1920, I changed the denominations to crores. It was lakhs. When you see the lakhs, the numbers are big. Because numbers are big, you can change it to crores. When numbers are very, really small, you can change it to rupees also. So that it's easy to see the numbers. Depends on the volume of your data. That real numbers depends on the real numbers. Total collection, this much is collected. Overall, because this is an overview dashboard, across this much is collected. target collection is this and top three performing, top bottom three performing. See, all these we configured. Whatever Punjab needed, we configured as per the Punjab requirements. We can change all these as per client requirement. I will show you that later. So let's see PropertyDAX dashboard. Okay, here only I missed one thing. So here if you see, there is something called two tabs are here. Revenue tab and service tab. Revenue tab, inside this tab, you'll see all the visualization related to money, means collection, revenue. Then it talks about mostly collection. So that is our decision. You can put that. Even this tabbing also, you can have multiple tabs, you can have single tab, everything is configurable. Okay. When you go to service, this application, closed application, SLA achieved, means basically applications other than revenue part, we'll see here. Depends on that applications, top three, bottom three, all everything is there. Let's see PropertyDAX, one of the complex module where you will see huge data also. So I'm audible, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So this is PropertyDAX dashboard. When you see revenue, this is today's collection. Today this much is collected in PropertyDAX. Today. But I filtered the data to 1920 financial year. So in 1920, this much is collected. This much was the target collection. This is the target achieved. And in 1920 data, these are the three top performing ULBs. Still you can see more ULBs in the order of target achievement. Here also you can see more, and this, how many in this visualization, how many you want to show, 1 or 2 or 5 or 10, that also is configurable. I'll show you that. And this is collection by uses, and this is one table data. Tables are there. One good features here are see, there is a toggle tab here. I'm saying boundary. When you say boundary, you can drill down to boundary. When you say uses wise data will come. When you say boundary, so here DDRs are there. The requirement for Punjab is they want to see the data DDR wise. Under DDR, there will be ULBs. This DDR has only one ULB. Let's go to some other. Bathinda DDR. Under this Bathinda, there are 31 ULBs. Default, we are showing 10. You can change that. How many you want to see? So all 50, all 31 ULBs we are seeing here. See, from each ULB again, you can drill down to a boundary level, ward level. Ward level data also you can see. This filter is going. And uses. Even now, the usage-wise data you are seeing for Bathinda, under Bathinda DDR for Maluka. ULB name is Maluka. Okay. The tables are like that. Even one more table here, tax head-wise data. Similar thing only. Again, you can filter all these. And these tables you can sort by any columns. Just click here. This is sortable. And this is search, a free search. You can search with number, text, anything. Suppose I'm just typing Hoshiarpur, it gives that. Matching with 2, it will give. 22, it will give. Okay, this is a high level. What kind of, if you have gone through that documentation, what kind of visualizations are supported? How to configure a visualization? How to design your visualization, how to place your visualization in your application. Everything is explained very detailed. I will also explain. I'll show you the configurations also here. And along with these, your dashboards can be downloaded into PDF image. and your dashboards can be shared through WhatsApp and mail also. Because if you download PDF, whatever the full dashboard will be downloaded into PDF. It's taking time.
We can decide. Actually,
yeah, please.
In that financial year, when we are selecting 1920 and it's showing the overview is showing for the current, for today's date.
Yeah, today's date.
How we are showing that it's a 9197 means more than 100% cross, or that who is defining this parameter? Actually,
client has to define. You are saying talking about target, right?
Target.
Yeah, target collection will be given by your client.
Okay.
I'll tell you how to means where we are. I will go into more details. I'm just explaining you what is there as of now in the application that I'm explaining. I'll explain you more detail about that. You can keep, you can ask questions now also. You can keep that questions also. After that, we can discuss.
Okay. And what is DDR as such? Full form of DDR?
DDR is, this is very specific to Punjab. Basically, it's a regions. In a state, there will be regions, right?
Okay.
Under region, states will come, districts will come, under districts, ULBs will come, right? Punjab calls it as a DDR. It's basically regions.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Something is wrong. Wait.
Ramki, your total collection you're comparing for the entire year, right? 98% down means it is for
the entire year. Yes, Pradeep. Whatever date range you are seeing here for that date range. So the image is downloaded like this. And along with this, you can download individual visualizations also. You can share and download same way. If you download image, you can just that visualization will be shared. And for tables, you can download into Excel. Whatever data you are seeing, that you can download into Excel. So all these features are there. I shown one revenue dashboard. Okay, let's see service side also.
Ramki, service side you can quickly touch upon because they are more interested in the revenue. They are not going to use
PGA. Okay. Yeah, service side also, the other like application side, based on number of applications approved, which are in progress, that level only. For comes to proper desk, they wanted these assessments, year-wise assessments in the table we have given. You can see DDR wise under this, again ward wise, how many application, year wise, and you can download this data. And I'll just show you this is a revenue, one of the revenue module I shown. I'll just show you one, this compliance system. This will not have a revenue, but compliance, only service tab we have put. So these are also different visualizations what we have defined. Okay, we'll go to the code and the configuration part. So this entire configuration, this dashboard in data, input data is a elastic indexes, and you have to write your DSL queries in a given JSON file with required configuration. Let me show you the configurations. Here, there is something called master dashboard config and chart API config. The master dashboard config here where we define what kind of dashboards you need, what are the visualizations you need. If you have gone through that documentation, this documentation talks about all kind of abbreviation, means these are the abbreviations, and what are the supported visualization, everything is mentioned here. Supported visualization somewhere here will be there. Yeah, these are the chart types available. What are metric, pile, line, perform, table, less table, all these things. So if you see here, this is completely JSON based. This is your configuration file. the two configuration files, master data configuration, chart API configuration. Let's go to this master dashboard configuration. See, the visualizations is an array. Sorry, dashboard system. Yeah. See here, these are all multiple dashboards, what we have seen here. The first one, if you see, the name of the dashboard is DSS underscore overview dashboard. The keys are defined here. These keys only used in our localization. In our Digit platform, we have localization service, right? These are the keys used in our localization. You can name, you can put the your localization value here. Suppose if you see overview here, this is an overview show dashboard. Whatever you are seeing is replaced for this key. Some ID is active, that is fine. Now, so for this overview dashboard, what are the visualizations you want? So we have, we see here, overview dashboard, we have multiple visualizations, right? So that's why this is an array. Under this array, we have, again, for this overview dashboard, we have revenue and service, two tabs are there. So each tab has, so the under revenue visualization, under revenue tab, what are the visualization? These are the visualization comes under revenue dashboard. If you see here, DSS overview, today's collection. So DSS overview is one of the chart. So under chart, what are the values you want? Like today's collection, total collection, all these we define. Again, this is a total collection today, right? This is a total collection, today's collection. And second one, the cumulative collection. This is a one more visualization. This is a cumulative collection visualization. Okay. And if you see here, for every visualization, you can define what is the width, what is the height also. So in your page, how many visualizations you want here, depends on number of visualization, you can change your, and depends on that KPI also. Suppose see, this needs a big size, the visualization. This doesn't need this much size. So you can define that size, your visualization size also here. You can configure that really. Everything you can configure here, whatever you configure here, you see there. And it's collapsible or yes, true or false. No unit means here we have denominations, right? We are changing, depends on this they don't want. No unit, true means that will not be applied. Okay, and this is revenue again. Okay. So again, we are defining that. This visualization also comes under revenue. Again, if you go down under DSS service, under service tab, whatever visualizations you want to see, here it is there. And if you see here, we are defining that row also. So these are the rows. This comes in a first row, second row, you can define third row. So the rows also we are defining, in which row also it has to come. So like this, we define the dashboards. So if you see here, overview dashboard, this is the complete data, means configuration, what we have done for overview dashboard. If you see this now, so this is only for that overview dashboard, what are the visualizations we wanted. Once you define what kind of visualizations, here we are just defining what is that my visualization name, the height, width, placeholder, which row, in which row it has to come, these things only we are defining. When you go to this chart API configuration, for the same visualizations what we defined in our master dashboard config, for that, in that visualization, what kind of data you want to see, how you want, means what kind of data really, from which index, from which index defines again module index, you can pick your index for your module. So those will be the actual query, DSL query we are talking about, right? Those things will be defined here. Those things will be written here. See, these are chart name DSS total collection, right? So this is the chart. So whatever you write, we are saying chart name, this is a chart here. So under charts only the name is coming. So whatever under chart you are writing here, total collection. So this data will be fetched and painted in this particular visualization. Okay. But here some rules are there. So the actual query is this. So this is a basic query, and on top, this is the same query used when we filter the data here. When we sort or filter, the data will be fetched from the same query. Depends on these filters will be applied whenever we apply these filters. So for that also, for that only we have all these inputs. What is a module? Date field, what is the date field in your index? So what is the index name we have defined here? This is the index. So in this index, what is the date field for you? So when you, this is the date field, when you change the date here, really that filter will apply on this particular field from the index, that given index. And when there is a word ID also, so when you want to filter, see here we have in a table you have a drill down from DDR to ULB to word level, right? So you need to really give what is a word identification in your index. So when I say here Ludhiana DDR, under Ludhiana this Khanna word wise, how we are getting this word wise data means in this index we'll group by this particular field. When you are saying your word field identification is this word name dot key keyword, and what is a module, because module also important, because some indexes might be having a data across the modules, like collection index is a single index, but it holds trade license collection, your property tax collection, your miscellaneous collection, all various collections happens in the your respective state or ULB. So you have to really give the module also, what is a module, to filter the data to that particular module. And tenant also, because here if you see here under DDR for Nangal, this is actually ULB. For Nangal to fetch all this data, I have DSS has to group by your tenant. What is the tenant field in your index? And what is the district? All this information is given here. So this is input stand. It's kind of a standard templates defined for DSS. We have to follow these templates and give right values to that fields, that parameters, so that DSS can fetch the data as per your filters, as per your requirements. So DSS collection, if you see here, module PT and TL. Whatever collection, so this particular query takes the data for PT, this particular query takes the data for TL. When you see overview, it combines both, means it sums up both the collections, and it will show you in the overview dashboard. Because the overview is a sum of all these things, right? It happens like that. And this total, when you see this total collection, these are the query part we have given, including all the filter parameters, everything, date parameter, module, word, everything. Then you are defining what kind of chart it is, how you want to see. Like it's a metric chart. The output, what is this? Is the amounts, and if it is amount, you'll really see this rupee symbol, lakhs, and you can apply the denominations, all these things you can apply when it is amount. When value type is not amount, these things will not be applied. If you see service, Here there is no rupees or these denominations will not, doesn't matter. If you change this, these numbers is not going to change. Why? Because for this particular chart, for this particular, the value amount, value type, we have not given as an amount. If you give amount only, that works there. And is it drill down chart? For this, it's not drill down chart. Some place wherever we have seen the drill down, there it will be true. Okay. And what is the aggregation part? This is more important when you're writing a query. If you see here, in your query, because everything mostly we do group by. I'm telling in the simple SQL language, this is also DSL, also kind of a query language. You have to do that aggregations, right? It's aggregation. So what is your aggregation path? In here, I'm giving aggregation path total collection. So when this query returns, the results also with this key, kind of a map, it will result, gives the results with the key as a total collection. So you have to mention, this is very important. Don't for if you do mistake here, if you by mistake, if you give something else, you will not get that data really. So these aggregation paths, whatever aggregation paths in your query, you have to mention those paths here. And these are all about what type of chart it is, whether it's amount or not, drill down is true or false, all these things, aggregation part. When it comes to still some more are there, like insights. Here important is here inside. Here this is important. For insights, we have given a text message, some message. If you see here, indicator. This is a standard word. Value and some static we are giving, insight interval. If you see insight interval, it's a year. I'll explain you what it is actually. If you see here, this is how still we are talking about total collection. Total collection, let's go to revenue. This is the field we are exploring. Whatever we are discussing here, everything's for this particular field. Okay. If you see here, indicator is there. This is what indicator, text message indicator, and it shows the value. Then last, this is static data, static text. Then last, what is our insight interval? We said insight interval is a year. That's why you're seeing it's a year. If you say insight interval, the allowed values are year, month, week, day. You can say insight interval month also, week also, day also. I'll tell you what is the meaning. When what is the meaning of this insight interval is, it's going to compare the data we have given here as a year, right? Last year data it will compare. Suppose I'm seeing data for 2021. So this particular value is going to compare with 1920 data. So let's put it in a crores. So in this 2021, 1.47 crores is collected. This is 98.7 less compared to last year 1920. The indicators are given like that. Okay. But target achievement compared with this total collection and this target collection. This is different, but insights is like this. If I change this to, if I change this to month, this will be compared. This data will be compared. Now we are in a month of, because it depends on what is the date range you selected. So custom date range also, you can do custom also. Suppose I'll change this to some April 1st to, April 30th. So my date range is this. So April 2020, this much collection is happened. Let's go to lakhs. This is a small number, right? If you go to units, you will see actual number. See, it's a 6 lakh one. This is the number. So now this number is compared with April 2019. So compared to April 2019, this is this much less. It happens like that. Okay. the meaning of insight interval is that. And if you want, this comments is basically on mouse over what you want to see in the for that particular visualization. So this is a very very detailed explanation of one visualization. We have seen one visualization which is one field only, just inside a visualization one field. If you see this cumulative, your query might change. Let's go to that. This is a cumulative collection, right? If you see here, there is no insights. It's completely empty. What is your chart type? It's a line chart. What is your value type? It's an amount. There is no drill down. What is your aggregation? Aggregation is a collections. And other things will be there. What is your date field? Because if I change the date here, I change the date, whatever I apply below this, whatever the visualizations you are seeing, everything will be applied with this filter. Okay. So that's why every query, every visualization DSL, every visualization DSL should have these information. So that DSS can filter depends on your, whenever you do that, apply the filter. So this is the query for a particular visualization. Here you can observe one more thing. These escape characters are there. That is a standard. When you really run this, what is the index? Index name is DSS collection V2, right? DSS collection V2. So this is your query. You can see the data here. What happened? I think this is a query, direct query, which something is missing. I think we can try this query because some filters has to be added there. I just took a raw query. So this is the query what we have given there. On top of that, depends on your filters and all, things will be applied. It will be keep adding to this query and it will fetch the result. Why I did this query? So our aggregation path is this. So the result is this one. This is the number we have, application is going to take and put it, show it in the application, depends on your filter when this query results returned. Okay.
Are you directly querying it from the Elasticsearch?
Yeah. Just to show example to you, I'm running it on, this is Elastic in Elastic server, Kibana connected to Elastic. I'm just showing.
Okay.
So like this, different type of charts will be there. If you see the charts, this is a metric, this is a line chart, metric, pie chart. So this is a total collection department wise, right? Department wise collection, if we see here, this is not used, it seems. I think there is a one more usage. This is trade license by type. See here, this is a chart, pie chart. And what is a value type is number. So when you see your pie, these numbers are not going to change, depends on your denomination, because we are not, we said value type is number, we didn't say it's an amount. There is no insights also for this, because like this comparison with last year and all, we don't want here, we didn't put that insights here. Okay, so very high level, this is how to add, how to add your dashboard, how to I'm not covering here the DSL part, hoping everybody knows DSL, but you as per your requirement, as per your client KPIs, you have to write your DSL query. You have to put, give your, what are the filters, different filters like module, date, and tenant, and district, and what, all these fields. You'll be aware that, you'll be knowing that those things has to be given here. Okay, whatever you assign here, the name, whatever chart name you are giving here, for that particular chart name, you have to come and write your query, you can add here. So this is very high level, what you have to do for to build a dashboard. Okay, there are I will show you one more thing. Any queries, I'll pause here. If you have any queries, we'll answer, we'll discuss those, then I'll move forward.
So the data what we push with the indexer is solely dependent on what needs to be displayed in the dashboard, right?
Yeah. Means is index, if you are defining indexes only for this purpose, obviously yes. And it's a complete, it's up to you completely how you design, how you define your index. You can push the data in that way.
Okay.
So if you have multiple requirements, one thing you want to pull the data for dashboard, one another thing you want to pull data from index for different purposes, you have to meet both the purposes while designing your index.
Okay.
Yes.
In case of, see, we are having the option of select the start date and end date also. So if the end date is normally, and in the next overview part, we are showing for the today's date. So if the today's date is like, for example, you have selected 1st April to 30th April.
Yes.
While in overview, we show the date for the, till today, what is the status?
Till today means this financial year, April 1st, 2022, till today, May 27th, 2020.
Yeah, so in that case, overview, it shows for the 30th April, right? This overview part in units. Means the total collection, when we do the query and it shows a 198.67 less than last year. So what it considered? It considered the 30th April or it considered the 27th May?
Because in insights already we configured it as a year. Okay, you are saying no. Because your when your filter is full year, it is going to compare with full year. When is your filter is date range for 7 days, it's going to compare for those 7 days in last year.
Okay.
Yes.
So this overview part actually, you were saying, right, overview part shows for the current day, for that financial year.
Current financial year.
Current financial year. Okay.
Overview here, still you can filter your data with date range, but when the landing page is there, right, here you are not able, you cannot filter your date with any of the filters. This is very fixed, with fixed filters that data is very high level numbers.
Okay.
Yeah. See, here you are not seeing any filters.
Right.
As soon as you click on this show dashboard, you are landing to this page. This is for current financial year. Here we are, it's showing the date also. Okay. From April 1st, 2022, May 27, 2020.
And again, yeah, we can continue. I'll ask later.
In the UI side, what is the package name for this dashboard?
We are using React only.
No, React as a dev package name, means HRMS or something.
HR means
no, you what mean is the framework? React app name, huh? React like we are yesterday we saw different packages. CRS. Okay.
This dashboard is not built on a Ego UI framework. This is a native React we used. We can share those code base details. So, Elgar, okay. You can share, right? We'll share, but
yes, we can share later.
Yeah. DS is not built on Ego UA framework. It's built on completely native React.
Okay.
And once again, the same question put in a different way. The dashboard only fetches the data from Elasticsearch, and it is not consuming any other service data, right?
Yes. Service? Okay. No. You mean? What do you mean by service?
Means any other APIs. I mean, data from any other database. I mean, Postgres. It is not coming from data.
No. DSS purely works on Elastic Index.
Okay.
Maybe localization changes. Maybe we're using.
Pradeep.
Localization changes.
Localization, I showed you, right? Here, what are the keys are there? See, their chart name DSS_TL, this is the license type. Whatever name you give, this is our Digit platform localization service is there, right? It's going to use the same localization. And it shows the data. All other things.
Yeah, only for the localization data, it comes from the respective place. Other than that, the other actual data gets generated.
Yeah, the numbers, whatever you see is from Elastic Index. Other things you can see, this menu tree also comes from MDMS. This localization
localization that is understood. Yeah. Understood.
Framework related we didn't use because this DSS needs a very different layout and all, right? Whatever you see, PGR properties, that is different. Like you'll have a text fields, drop downs. This is completely different. So we didn't build any UI framework for this. This is purely designed, developed on native React.
Okay.
Yeah. And it uses everything, even if you see here, share the PDF. If I say share image here, it will open your web WhatsApp, and in a Digit platform there is a tiny URL app, one service is there. It's going to use the same service. Okay. And when it open all other Digit the core services are utilized here. Everything is this built on a Digit platform, right? This is not connecting, but you can see mail. You can see it will show you that, and it's going to open in your default whatever mail you configured. So it's going to send you a tiny URL, URL shortening one service is there on Digit platform, right? So I can send this to anybody. This is a free URL. Just you open that URL, it will download you that file for you. Okay. Any more questions?
This PDF means it will again hit the PDF service or
it's not that PDF service. It's a screen capture kind of, it's a different way in the React only.
Okay, whatever you see in the browser, that will be captured and PDF is generated.
Correct. Whatever you see. Okay. Completely.
Okay.
For image and PDF both.
Okay.
Rama, one thing, like we are having one UI React that is in React Native, then. You are defining the in the UI package only, you are defining all the indexer related code, or it's again a part of different service?
Yeah, for dashboard, there are three services. One is analytics, one is ingest, one is to do this backend and front end thing. The There are three different services for DSS.
Okay, and that is defined in your document as such, right?
Document defines all these things.
Okay.
Document docs are
missed that link. We couldn't either we missed it or so what? We couldn't read that link.
Now, after our session, you go through that, it will be more clear.
Okay.
Whatever I was talking here, document talks about all these things.
Okay.
Yeah.
And as such, your service analytics and ingest all this are in microservice only, Spring, or again, it's in Node.js or other platform?
No, it's a Spring.
Okay.
Spring and frontend, React, and the configuration is JSON.
Okay. And your configuration file, again, it's a part of Git or yes. Again?
Okay. Git.
It's in analytics folder only, or again, it's a part of MDMS, some configuration or different part?
No, it's a, we have a config folder, right? One config repository we have, right?
Okay.
So there is a configs folder you might have seen. This where MDMS indexer persister is there, like that. One more for dashboard. Okay. This is ego dashboard. Your analytics configurations are here. Your ingest configurations are here. So far I didn't speak about ingest. I'll let you know. I'll tell you after this. Under analytics, whatever we saw, master dashboard config and chart API config. These are the depends on your requirement, keep changing. These files are going to keep changing. Others are very one-time configuration. You'll come, documentation speak about all this configuration.
Okay.
And these Git paths, you have to give it in an analytics service, dashboard analytics service.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. We can move forward.
Yeah.
So here we are seeing the comparison. We are talking about this insights, right? These numbers, how did this come? This is compared to last year, but there is a targets, right? How we have to load the target. There is some. There is a separate index for this target. DSS target V1, the structure is defined, the data looks like this. So depends on how you collect the data, it's important, but structure is like this. For each financial year, we see here, financial year, business service, that's just ULB name, and what is the budget, this is the target basically. For PIL, for 1920, for PT, this is the target to be collected. So now we see data for particular PIL, you will be here. The data will be compared with this number. This is a financial year data. Again, your insights are 1 month, it's a month. This will be taken for month, means it's a year data, right? By 12, it will be, by 12, then the data will be taken for a month and will be compared. When your insight is month, as of now the insights configuration, the interval is there, right? We have seen that. Where is that? Yeah, insight interval is there, right? Here, if you say month, this data from year data, the DSS will take the data for month and it will compare and it will show you the targets and percentages here. Okay, so to load this data, there are APIs. That's what we have seen one thing as a ingest, right? There is a dashboard ingest. This service is going to help to load this kind of static data. There are APIs for this. There is an ingest API. You can put the data into that API. You can give the data to that API. It's going to push the data into Elastic Index. And one more important thing here. See, I'm just explaining very detailed. There is one more service. There are four indexes. These are the indexes comes from our Digit platform services. These are TL index, PT index, PGR, and collection. If you see this collection is going to have data for entire all the revenue modules data. By saying there is some field called business service. Yeah, the business service is PT. This is a PT collection. So if you see these dashboards, we need a collection by usage, but collection the collection index really will not have a usage of that particular PT entity. And we have we have target, this is okay. And along with this collection, we need to get assessed properties, what are the transactions, total collection is okay. Again, this key financially, and this is okay. But if you see here, very specific to property tax, when we are seeing a property collection, collection really doesn't own this kind of information which is related, which is owned by property, like uses, the property number of properties assessed, because the property might be assessed but collection might not be there, because there are 1 lakh properties are assessed, doesn't mean all property owners paid their tax, right? The taxes are, collection index will own how many collections are happened. It's not going to own how many properties are there in a system. That is going to own by a PT index. So our client requirements will be like this, and it's very genuine requirements. We need to fulfill those requirements. To overcome these kind of requirements only, for Punjab, we have this come out of collection PT TL. We have designed one more index. This will have more information along with the collection, the domain information also. So here, if you see, this is one document from that index. Let's analyze this data. Let's see this data. So if this is one document from that particular index. If you see here, there is something called data object and there is something called domain object, right? So domain object owns domain, under domain object, the actual, the domain like property, this is the PT collection. That's why you see property detail. If you take the if you take TL collection, in under domain object, TL object will be there. So all the information under same index, it's easy for you to write a DSL query however you want, because collection by usage under property detail, you will find that usage of the property under this. If you see here, you can really see that usage. So you can group by that and you can fulfill this kind of requirement. Even for these transactions also, you can do that way. So for this kind of things, the ingest service is going to help us. Okay. For this kind of purposes, index service is going to help. How it is means. So now out of multiple indexes, like out of all these indexes, from these indexes, we are building this index. And what is the structure of this index? You have to define. That's what we are calling it as a, if you go under ingest, there are so many configurations. See, we are name, all these are, you can put any name. This will be, you have to input into ingest service configuration. That is okay, but you can follow the standard names also. So collection domain config. Okay, here we are configuring if the business type is PT, because in collection, let me explain what it is actually. The DSS collection V2, we are saying this index will own all the collections happen and have in this index. For each document, for each collection, if this is a PT collection, this along with that data object, what is the PT collection, the domain object, PT details has to be captured. For that, this is the configuration we have written here. So when business key is PT, you get the data from PT index because you'll get the data from property tax index. And what is a query? It's to filter, because from this document, you can get that business key of the property tax in the PT index. What is the field you need to put in, how you have to filter that data? Also, you are giving here, and what kind of data, everything you are giving here. Second, if it is a TL, business key is TL, get the data from TL and put it in a domain object. All these kind of configurations are defined here. And there is an API to ingest. There is one more API to process this data. As per your configurations, whatever you have done under your ingest, as per your requirement, it's going to transform. It's going to read data from this collection index. Whenever it's a PT collection, it pull the PT property tax domain object. Whenever it's a TL collection, it's going to pull the data from this index and put it inside this, like this data object and domain object. That's where we have designed this. So the ingest service is going to help to transform your data into your required format. Okay. And the same ingest service is going to help us to load a static data. These target data targets are very static data, right? Once in a year only, you're in starting of the year, you're going to load your targets. Using that ingest service, we can load this data. Using that ingest service, we can transform the data also, really. And for Punjab, we did this transformation. If you see in our chart API configuration, most of the places will be using this is the index. Most of the places, like for wherever revenue part, mostly in the revenue part, we'll be using this, because under revenue part, combination of revenue and domain specific KPIs will be there. So we are using this index. Most of the collections will be by this index, revenue part. Yeah, this is about ingest service, how it works, how we can utilize that index service depends on our requirements. We can discuss if we have any queries now.
For dashboard related things, right? So ideally we are using the indexer data only. We are not making any specific flow for this dashboard, right? Okay. While saving time, I'm just asking, like whatever is data is getting saved in the database, at the same time it's getting saved in the as a log also, indexer log. So that data only you are using. You are not making any specific flow for dashboard related things.
No, we are not. We have for only for DSS. Whatever you see here, the indexes. These four, all these indexes from the whatever the flow, digit flow is there, from that on it's coming. But still you have this indexer config also, right? Here we have indexer configs also, right? You can change whatever you want to. It means your index has to what kind of data it has to own. If it is a code, if you want to pull the data from respect to master, all these things you can do in your indexer configs, right? That initial things we have done. But DSS we have developed recently, specifically for DSS, for these indexes, we have not done any major changes. It's a product flow only for this index, but this index we have built on top of these things.
Right. So you, and that is thing is like you have modified, obviously you have created a complete a new flow retrieval part, but while pushing into Elasticsearch, you have not pushed anything specific for the dashboard.
No, yes. From the application, we didn't push anything specific to DSS. Correct.
Because my point is, if in future, or means well, the customization, if the user requirement comes, like which is not part of normal index, means normal saving part. So do we entertain such request, or based on the available data only, we say this type of dashboard can be designed?
That's again, it's your call only. Okay. So Digit is giving re-indexing feature also. Indexing is going to happen part of your normal flow. When you create application, when you do collection, when you raise a complaint, part of that indexing is going to happen, and that indexing also going to happen on this configuration only, your indexer configuration only, right?
Right.
And here only digit, along with this digit, is giving a one more option. You can re-index your entire data. This is, I'm talking about very rare use cases. What you are talking also mostly rare use cases, because if you see our digit platform, the basic default configuration, basic configuration, suppose if you take a property, create property, part of these PT index -v1 is going to have all the data, whatever you see in the form. That's why mostly we'll push most of the data as a default configuration. If you see here, suppose PT, if you are taking, this is a PT data. Most of the data, whatever you fill in the form, whatever the master you are selecting, all the data will get pushed. It's a tree. You see that structure also very tree structured, right?
Mm-hmm.
Property, if you see property, there are multiple things. Everything will be stored here, mostly. Yeah. On top of that, if you see requirements where you can't fulfill with this data, I don't think so, because they cannot ask out of your box, right? Means from your form, your field, you are capturing 100 fields, all 100 fields are in your index. Only thing we are doing is wherever master is there, suppose ward code is there, instead of ward code, we'll get the name of the ward from the MDMS, we'll put that name of the ward in the index. Such kind of enrichments we'll do, but we'll not miss any of the data which is filled in form, as I know.
Okay.
You also aware of that, right? When you are when you are seeing this index, because our digit platform, the data comes in a JSON only, right? It's very much easy to push your JSON into your index. That just we are consuming entire JSON and pushing here, right? Mostly we follow the same structure, mostly, most of the cases.
Okay.
I don't think anything you will get out of the box requirement. Most of the requirements you can fulfill with what is the data available in your hand.
Okay.
But still, that is a very corner case, I can say, 100% I can say. But still, if you get that kind of corner case, platform has a feature to re-index your whole data, and you can continue with the same new structure, the added new fields, whatever it is, you can go with that same thing. You can re-index the entire data. That feature is there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ramakrishna, regarding this enrichment thing you're saying, right? So when the data, like suppose when the form is filled and then the data is supposed to be pushed, like
Navin, parallelly. Sorry, Navin, your voice is coming little low and breaking. Can you please? Some noise is coming in the background.
Hello. Not even
now. Yeah, better. Can you put your question again, please?
Yeah. Suppose if you are filling the form and when the data is being pushed parallelly into the DB and into the Elasticsearch, so the enrichment process happens like only for Elasticsearch, or for like enrichment process happens and after that the same data is being pushed to both ends?
Both are different. If you see the digit flow, the enrichment when you push to data to DB, enrichment is different. When you push data to index, the enrichment process is different. There is a one service called indexer. The enrichment will for Elastic Index, enrichment will happen there as per your configuration given in the index indexer config.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Thanks.
Any more queries?
Not at such.
Yeah. I have covered whatever is required. Okay. Yeah. Hi.
So, how we have you configured to Elasticsearch from your application? Like you are just making the queries in the JSON, right? So how it is hit the Elasticsearch URL and fetching the data?
So in your service, DSS service, like for every service, how you give your DB source, database details you are giving, right? Like that only Elastic Index details will give in our service for DSS services.
Okay, there is separate DSS service, this one backend code.
Yes, yes. There are three services I was telling, right? Let me show you that. There are three services for DSS. These are the three services is required. DSS dashboard is a front end. Whatever you are seeing, data painting is means the front end basically. This service is going to read the data from this analytics. Ingest service, what we discuss about the pushing data and transforming the data. This is the service for that. Here and here where you give that your Elasticsearch service okay. Server details.
Got it.
Yeah. So I have covered most of the things what is required for DSS. From my side, I have covered everything. If you guys have any queries, we can discuss that. From ego team also, most of the people join. We can discuss if you have anybody have queries. Any queries?
It's not related to this. I have a query related to BPA. So previously, in when we met, you were telling like it's in old stack only. And so this new property BPA is now shifted to new structure, microbase service base, and completely that flow. Just confirming that.
We have a solution on DZ platform also.
Okay.
Yeah. I didn't understand your query.
Okay. Huh? BPA is now completely migrated on this DZ platform, right?
Yes. Yes. Correct.
Okay. And still that course in which you are doing this validation and all that, it's still a jar file directly. As such, code is not available for that, right?
No. For this rules, you are saying, right?
Right.
Yeah, that's a jar file.
Oh.
I think we are good now, right? Anything else?
Actually,
yeah, Priyanka.
Yeah, actually, I was going through document and there was for ingest some configuration is there, like it's given in points 5, given that the ingest configuration, it is given in points.
Okay.
The document, one third point is like Jolt transformation schema.
Yeah, this is what I shown for this DSS collection index. We said there is a separate schema, right? That's a Jolt transformation schema. For that, we are using a Jolt schema.
And the one fifth point also, Jolt domain transformation schema is there.
Yeah, all these are under this same ingest only. So basically, when this data transformation happens, there is something called Jolt schema for JSON, supported by JSON only. That schema we have to follow. Those things are, when you go here, you can understand that. Okay.
Like one thing it is mentioned in third point, in generic weight we have to transform. Then in that fifth point it is written like we have to discard that unwanted ones.
Yeah, when you transform, see, you are going to build a new index as per your requirement. When from digit platform, what are the indexes are there? There you will have all the data, 100% data, whatever you fill it in the form, that data will be there. When you transform that, you can skip, you can really skip what you don't want.
It is like two files will be there or in one place itself?
Multiple files will be there.
Okay.
You go see transform PT here. You are very on top level. You write if it is a PT collection, you get the data from PT index. But here you are not telling what and all you have to consume. That is defined in transform PT V1. If you see here, what and all you want to consume. See property detail, complete property detail, property ID, tenant ID, ward information. These four fields only you are consuming.
So this transform PT which is required we are keeping, and in that collection domain we are keeping entire thing.
Correct, is it?
Okay, that's.
So all these configurations are inside that ingest. Okay. Ingest service properties you can see, there you can see. Okay, Priyanka.
Yeah, Ramki.
Yeah. If we don't have any more queries, I think we can close this session. I'm done with whatever is required. I explained most of the things. Go through the document. We can. It has all the details.
Can you share the link of that page, actually?
Yeah, this was already shared, right? As a pre-read, this has been shared. Confluence page, right?
I can share this.
I'm just pinging this in our group, here group chat only. You can read this.
Just one minute, because do we have access to that page? You just share it. Okay.
All Confluence pages are open pages. You'll have access.
Okay, yeah.
Actually do this, take this one. I just went to inside and open. You can really take this one.
Okay,
we are good.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks everybody.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thanks, Ramki.